Hey class, it's Mrs. Gilling here, and I am so excited to let you know a little bit more about your Unit 4 projects. It is rolling. I say that every video, but I just feel like time is going by so fast and you guys are getting so much work done, and I'm just excited to let you know more about this next project. So as always, you will have two options. You can either do the writing project that's found in Flip Switch, or you can do the video project that's found in our Google Classroom. I want to start with the writing project and let you know a few important details. I really, really, really want you to pay attention to this because I think I have found a way to make this project easier for you and also more beneficial for you to really understand and see the information you need to get. So starting off, this is the information that you can find in the course under the Unit 4 project. Let me read just a little bit to you. It says, research suggests that participation in sports reflects geographic and economic factors. Think of a sport that doesn't require lots of equipment or special clothing to play. One such sport is basketball. All a player needs is a ball and somewhere to shoot. In this project, you will research several major sports: football, basketball, hockey, skiing, tennis, and golf. Your goal is to discover where and by whom these sports are typically played. Also, find out what is the cost for someone who is not a professional to play these six sports. So what Flip Switch is telling you to do is to research those six sports, figure out what kind of equipment you need to play them, figure out who plays them, where they're played, and what it costs to play the sport. And Flip Switch wants you to write a 5-paragraph essay. To be completely honest, when I think about that, I think that'd be kind of a boring essay to read. It would just be a lot of figures spitting out. And I think it would be hard for you to really comprise that into one little essay and try to make it interesting for you to write. So being the kind, loving teacher I am, I have made you a chart that is going to make this a lot easier. So here is the chart I've created. So I still want you to research the six different sports, but instead of putting an essay form, all you need to do is fill out the chart. So for instance, you'll go and you'll research football. You'll Google football and say, where is football played? And you'll put that information there, or you could go look up in a book, anything that works for you, the way you prefer to do your research. So then you'll fill it in there. You'll answer who plays it, how much does it cost to play, and what are some of the expenses. Let me differentiate between these two boxes for a second. On how much it costs to does it cost to play, I want you to think on either a monthly or a yearly basis. How much is it going to cost that person monetarily overall to pay to play that sport? In this box, I want you to list what are the things that make it so expensive. What do you need to buy? For instance, in football, do you need to buy a ball? Do you need to buy cleats? Are there membership fees, gym fees, those sorts of things? So this is an actual number. And again, I know you may not be able to find things perfect, but do your best and come up with the amount it costs to play and then what are some of the expenses. Now, you can also think outside the box on this. You don't have to Google it, go online to try and find, or look in the newspaper. You could call up a football coach that you've had in the past, or maybe one that your brothers or sisters have. Call up a local high school, anything along those lines, and just ask them, how much does it cost to play this sport? People love to talk about things that they care about, and a football coach is going to be excited to talk to you about their sport. So if you like talking to people, like picking up the phone, feel free to give them a call. What I do need you to do, no matter where you get your information, is to cite it. So I've created this citations box for you. If you used a website, I want you to give me the link to it. If you called someone up, I want you to give me the name. I know that you didn't just make this stuff out of thin air, so I need your citations. I won't be able to grade this properly if I don't have those citations. I think the way that I've set it up makes it easy for you to not have to do a ton of writing, so I will expect you to have those citations in there for me to see. So after you've done all of your research for the six sports, football, basketball, hockey, skiing, tennis, and golf, and you've given me your citations, you're going to sit back and think. You're going to look at all the data that you've gathered, and you're going to say, what did I learn from this? You may say, why is basketball so much more expensive than golf? I don't know if that's true or not, but you're going to look at your data and figure that out. And you're going to come up with some conclusions. Why is basketball played in this part of the world and not in this part of the world? And just come up with some answers. And I want you down at the bottom to write me a short essay, a paragraph, 3 to 5 sentences. Tell me what you learned from your research, analyzing and breaking down. Because it doesn't do you a whole lot of good to do a bunch of research just for it to sit there. Say, okay, I looked it up and there's numbers and not think about it. I want you to break it down and tell me, what did you actually learn from it? Now I'm going to give you two options to turn this in. If you would like, you can go ahead and just turn it in Google Classroom. I think that's the easiest method to do it. I've gone ahead and uploaded it in there. I'll show you right here. You can see that right here in Google Classrooms is the Unit 4 writing project. I've made a copy for each of you so you can fill it up and just send it in there and I'll know to grade it. Or I'll also go ahead and put an attachment in FlipSwitch for you to do. Now, if you would prefer to write an essay, I'm fine with that. If you'd rather do the 5-paragraph essay, I just think it would be easier to use this chart, but whatever works best for you. So if you're into sports or into geography and learning about different parts of the world, I would highly recommend doing this project. But remember, you are supposed to do three writing projects and three video projects. So if you've already done three of the writing projects, I'll need you to choose the video project instead, and vice versa. If you've already done three video projects, then you'll need to complete this writing project. So if you have any questions, as always, I say this every time, but go ahead, give me a call, send me an email. I'm pretty free and excited and willing to answer your questions. So let's take a look now at the video project. And as always, it is found in the Google Classroom. So what you'll do is go down to the Unit 4 video project and you will watch this video. It is called Dropout Nation. It's put on by Frontline. It's a PBS thing. I really like this video because in your unit, you learn about education and how it's an important institution. Education and schools, they're not just there to help you learn facts. It's not just there to help you learn that 1 + 1 = 2 or that Christopher Columbus sailed the world. That's important, and we need to learn those things. But another reason why we have school is to help us become good members of society and help us to learn how to participate in this big world that we're a part of. And I like this video because it lets you follow the lives of four students who had kind of rough lives that didn't come from the best of situations. They may be people that you can relate to. Maybe you've gone through some of those things, or maybe you have friends or family members that have. But it helps you see the effect that school has on their lives. I'm gonna have this project be a little bit different than the video projects you've had in the past. Instead of sitting down and answering a bunch of different questions that just follow the video along and then answering some short essays, I'm only gonna have you write four or f excuse me, five different paragraphs. They're not super long, they're not super hard, but you're gonna, instead of taking notes throughout the whole thing and writing specific answers, I want you to sit and focus on these four students and their lives. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull this up for you here. So this is what you're gonna do. For each of the following students, the four students that are talked about in the video, you're going to write a short essay, 5 sentences, answering each of these questions. 1, what struggles did the student face? 2, what did the educators do to try and help them succeed? And number 3, in your opinion, do you think the school helped the student to be more successful? Why or why not? As you answer these questions about the students, I want you to make sure to give me specific answers to specific details to support your answers. Don't just say, the student had a hard life because they had a hard life. Be specific. Say the student had a hard life because they were homeless and their parents were addicted to drugs. Point to specific things that you found in the video. And then when it comes to what did the educators do, again, don't just say, oh, well, they were nice to them. Tell me what they did. Did they stay after school to help them? Did they provide a different avenue to learn? What specific things did they do? And then remember, number 3, after you've watched the video and seen everything, do you think that the school helped them to be more successful? Why or why not? And that's where your feelings come in. So do that. You need a paragraph for each of the students. So for Lawrence, Marco, Sparkle, and Marcus. And you'll come to know them as you watch the video. After you've watched the video and you've filled out your paragraphs for each of these, I want you to answer one more question. And that question is, how has education affected your life? So after watching that and seeing what those teachers and that administration had done for those students, think back on your own life. What has being a part of a school done for you? It doesn't have to be I succeed, it can be, but what any school that you've been a part of, your overall experience, what has that meant to you? How has that affected your life? And be honest, if it's been negative, say that. If it's been positive, say that. I just want to see that you are really taking in the video and taking in the things you're learning in FlipSwitch and trying to apply it to your surroundings. When you're done with this, as always, you'll go ahead and submit it via our Google Classrooms and I'll go ahead and grade it. And you can find the videos, like I said, right here under Unit 4 Video Project. This one, usually they're YouTube videos. This one you're going to go to PBS website, but this should bring you right to the link, right to the page. You click on it, press play, and watch it. It's about an hour and 50 minutes, but it's really good. I think you'll see that it flies by and that you'll really like it. So that's option number two. Again, if you haven't done any video projects, you're going to want to do this one. And if you haven't done any writing projects, you're going to definitely want to do the writing project. Definitely, as always, let me know if you have any questions. But please, 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 after you've watched this video, turn in the video assignment that's here. I will post it as soon as I'm done writing the video. I'm sorry, as soon as I'm done uploading the video. But it'll look like this, but it'll say Unit 4 Video Assignment. Watch the video, answer the questions. It's an easy percentage points in this class to do. I promise if you watch these videos, they will help you do better on your projects and it'll improve your grade. All you have to do is they're super simple, answer the questions, turn it in. So please, please, please turn those in and please let me know what I can do to help and have fun. I am super duper duper looking forward to reading what you write and seeing your research and helping you out. So there you have it, and enjoy the rest of your unit and the rest of your week, and we'll catch up with you guys next time.